Further ado, I'm going to get first comedian. She's absolutely phenomenal. She regularly performs at the Ontario Improv in the Pasadena Ice House. Please give a big warm, big first welcome to first comedian ever on this show, Dianna. Entire show. That's awesome. Thank you, Robin. So, what are you guys doing? Are you good? Well, that's fantastic. That's also a great crowd. I just love it. And my name is Lady Gaga. And I firmly believe that life begins at 40. But, absolutely. Because that makes me a 12-year-old virgin. Well, I love that opening joke, and it's going to be really sad when I have to get rid of it, because in November, I turn 53. The joke's just not going to work anymore, you know? Who's going to believe that tagline? That makes me a 13-year-old virgin. Well, there's a bunch of memory around. Sure. So, I'm 52, and I gotta tell you, I'm single, and dating in your 50s is no picnic. Oh, it's not. I'll tell you, when I'm on a date, and the sign above the building doesn't read active senior living, it's gonna be a good date. On the other hand, if you're ever by a guy's house, and I've had a first stack of the twins in the bathroom, yeah. That's so good. Well, here's why, as I know it's close to call. I went to dinner with a guy, and I think things are going quite nicely. You know, right in the middle of the meal, the alarm on his wristwatch goes off. Yeah. I'm wanting him to take his medication. That's so good. Unless he's got one of those cute little blue pills in his pill pocket. Wow. I can work with that. Absolutely. Here, honey, here's some water. Take your meds. Hey, check price book. Oh, that's crazy. I've tried it all too. I've tried internet dating. Oh, my God. How many women here have tried those sites? Oh, how many pills? I'm sorry, but it does. Every time I hear the advertisement, I watch 29 dimensions of your compatibility. Now I ask them, do not. I will tell you what they match me up with. Guess I'm a 5'2". I weigh a whopping 96 pounds. What am I supposed to do with that? I'm a petite man. I'm a petite man. I mean, I'm standing on the stage here at the Galaxy Theater. Is there anything about me that screams petite? Come on. That's crazy. For the high fancy benefits to internet sex. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Hey, you don't have to visit the doctor afterwards. I'll play a loop fog over the wet spot. Well, I tell you what, thank you. Well, you remember that, don't you? Well, the greatest benefit across the board, though, has got to be the fact that no one has to worry about getting knocked up. Right? Gosh, when I was at 52, that's not an issue with me anymore. Well, I won't get pregnant. I can't get pregnant. I had that shit taken out when they're putting my door up. We'll start shopping. I'll tell you, you know, dating in your 50s has its own set of rules. It does. I mean, look at these beautiful young girls here. When you're in your 20s and 30s, the basic rules of dating apply. You ladies can just go out to a club, spend a amount of interest, zero in that target, and bam, you have bagged your prey for the night, right? That'll make it difficult for you. But when you're at 52, moving on by at the end of the night is a restraining order. For stalking. Chris Hansen's girls have got the camera shoved in their face. CPS has got my phone number on speed dial. Come on, man. I'm not trying to commit a crime, man. I'm just trying to meet a need. For need, for meat. Here we go. So speaking of meat, I have to have 2 hours for this part of the program. Yes, speaking of meat. Do you have a right to go into the bedroom of a 50-something couple having sex? Can you go with me? Can you do it, guys? I can do this, right? We got strong rights, right? Now, for the first thing, we gotta keep the lights on just to set up all the equipment. No, I'm not kidding. Those blood pressure cuffs, penis pumps, defibrillators. Hey, you need an emergency generator just as being over all the opportunities, you know. You just gotta be safe. Well, I'll tell you what, I don't want the story, Mr. Serves, are getting halfway there. And then stopping on you. It's too hard to line yourself up. Oh, I can't bend that way anymore. I told you, put an artificial hip in the mix and see what kind of bag of goodies you got going. Oh, Ryan, you see me all my glory. Oh, God, my legs reaching up to my heavens. Oh, crap. Stick. Oh, no. This does not ask me where to score the extra points, boys. What it could mean is you are going to have a very embarrassing trip to the emergency room. Oh, Ryan. But before you can even do that, you're not supposed to get my panties on. And if you accomplish that, who's going to help me in the car? You're going to have to go into those really nasty like my cars to your buddy with a pickup truck. Load my ass in the back, strap me down with some bungee cords, just so you can get me to my final destination. Jiffy Lube. That's going to be a fun conversation with the mechanics. Hey, baby. Oh, my God, that was a lot of fun. Let's put this fuzz up on you, shitty bitch. Quick, hand me that grease gun. Stop it. Hey, you gangsters, you don't think about these things, but you will. Mark my words. I tell you, it's crazy. And I just think that the thing with dating in your 50s is there's too many restrictions. Just too damn many restrictions. I mean, I can't even date a guy if he's got allergies or asthma anymore. That's serious. I'll go in with him and he happens to get lucky. Oh my lord. The best guy to ever come out of this thing. It's scrambling for the empire. California wears on. Henry Boston is ours. I'm blinded. I love talking about his birthday, but that is not what I have in mind. That's frustrating. You know how many it is. Let me tell you, when all of that frustrating isn't crazy enough, I'm going to have no longer girlfriends. He was whining to me about how tough it is to date in their 30s. Please, give me a break. When you're a good looking chick in your 30s, every guy wants to hit on that. Can you hear me, man? How accommodated. I'm over 50. I can't give a shit about girls. To a brown man. Who's homeless. And when you're trying, I think I'm downright testing. You're like, oh, hey, lady dog, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure so listening. Bye-bye.